You ask questions, I answer. That's the premise of this series. It's about you, not me. Let's go. Welcome to Ask Qazi. This is a brand new series where I'm gonna take your questions from Instagram and other social media platforms. So I highly encourage you to drop a comment at the end of the video. Ask me anything, I do not care. Anything about filmmaking, freelance lifestyle, or even full-time job, I don't care. Just ask me a question down below and I will make sure to include it in the future episodes. Make sure to stick around till the end of the video. I'm gonna show you how to download my LUT pack. It's created by me. And it is all the essential LUTs that you need. You got the black and white film look LUT, you got a bleach bypass look, and then you got teal and orange. So you don't wanna miss this. I'm gonna show you how to download it at the end of the video. Guys, if you're enjoying the content on this channel, do not forget to hit a thumbs up, share it with friends, subscribe to my channel. Let's just get right into it. Go with the MacBook Pro, about 2 years old, a mid-tier, you know, 16 gigs of RAM, i7, and you'll be in great shape. So hardware requirements are simple. Minimum 8 gigs of VRAM, 16 gigs of RAM, flash drive for your scratch disk, so at least have 400 to 500 megabytes of read and write speed, 4-core i7 processor minimum, 8-core is better. So as a colorist, certification is not that important. It's just like a degree. Degree is not that important. Once your work speaks for itself, nothing else matters. But it's not just your showreel either. It has to be your presentation. It has to be your personality. And there's a lot of those aspects that go hand in hand. I will highly recommend you start giving Resolve a try for everything, end-to-end post-production. So you bring in your footage, you log it in Resolve, you edit in Resolve, you color in Resolve because it stays in one place, and then you deliver through Resolve. And you can deliver it in any format you want, and I think you should give it a try and see it for yourself. So I will highly recommend keeping your timeline in 1080p. It's just gonna be a lot smoother, the entire workflow, if you're working with tons of nodes or whatever. And then when you're exporting, just export it to native resolution or whatever you want to future-proof yourself. So in DaVinci Resolve, when you're color grading, you have just graded one shot, you're moving on to the next shot, and it can use the same grade. And if that's the case, you just hit the middle click on the thumbnail of the previous shot that you graded, and boom, it brings in all the nodes and everything, and you're done. Color correction is that process where if you see something on reality TV and it just looks good and poppy, that's color correction. Color grading is, you know, the movie 7. When you watch these movies that have this distinct look, whereas if you watch American Beauty, it will have a completely different look. If you watch Sinister or Saw, it has that green, like sickly look, and it gives you that feeling too, and your heart kind of sinks. So that is color grading, where you're like driving the entire story through the power of color. If you are on the go, if you grade on your laptop, something like that, I will highly recommend getting their Ultra Studio Mini. And it's just a little thing that you can just carry in your backpack, throw it and just, you know, go wherever. If you have a studio, right now I have the Ultra Studio 4K. So that's what I'm using. It's about $1,000 and you can pick it up cheaper on eBay or something like that. So it totally depends what you need. You can read through their products and it's very self-explanatory and just go from there. The difference between camera LUTs and creative LUTs is that, you know, if you're working with Sony log footage, let's say S-Log 2, a lot of the times people complain that their skin tones are completely off. It has that Hulk green, you know, cast. How do you take that out? Well, if you're just working off of primaries from a log image, a lot of the times it's going to be really hard to take it out yourself. But if you're applying their LUT, S-Log 2 to Rec. 709, they have already figured that out and they're gonna take that out for you, because each camera manufacturer is very specific with their color science, and their LUTs help you get to that point, you know, from point A to B really fast in the right way. And then based on that, you just build a color correction or color grade off of their LUTs. So Scope Box is a third-party scopes that I use, and I highly recommend giving it a shot. It's about $100, but the way to set it up is a little tricky. So you will need a couple of things. You will need an Ultra Studio recorder, mini recorder, and then that's gonna go from your computer into your Mac Mini. You have to buy like a Mac Mini or something like that. And then that Mac Mini is gonna have Scope Box open, and then that's gonna be going into a monitor through HDMI to give you that live feed off of your main computer that you're color grading on. So it's a little like, you know, you really have to get that concept down, but they're worth it because that right there is the Scope Box. That's what I'm using. And the granular aspects of the scopes and the things that you can see there, it's just so binary, it's so black and white that it makes all the difference in the world. Resolve has two versions. So one is just DaVinci Resolve. The other one is DaVinci Resolve Studio. DaVinci Resolve is free. So you can download it today and start playing with it. Not a trial version. This is just a full software for free. Unbelievable, insane value. Second version is Studio, which I recommend. It's $299. It's only $300. It comes with high-end Resolve OFX and some advanced noise reduction features that you don't get otherwise. This is my personal method that I use. So a lot of the times with digital cameras, you're getting this digital noise, the RGB noise, and it's like kind of gunky and ugly. So you wanna take that out. So you start off with applying noise reduction. So to take that out and have a pristine image. And then at the end, I usually add monochromatic grain, which is basically gives it a film character, because when you shoot on film, you have grain embedded into your image. So adding grain gives it that weight, gives it that character. Taking out noise, you know, which is the digital noise, make the image pristine and very clean. Now let's talk about the freebies. So the link is in the description down below. Click on that link, download the LUTs. And guys, the way I created these LUTs is that you can apply them on your primary corrected image. So just go ahead and tweak your image a little bit, get it in the ballpark, apply this look, and then you should get your desired results. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Make sure to subscribe, hit a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and I will see you in the next episode.